The campaign trail is a grueling battleground. It is relentless and unforgiving. Every moment is under a microscope. Every move is analysed, and it leaves no room for error. It can unravel even the most seasoned politicians. In this Sky News digital special, your favourite hosts reveal their top losers from the US election campaign trail. Sky News Digital Originals presents Campaign Trail Losers.
Look, when you're talking about the loser of the campaign, you can't go beyond Kamala Harris. I know it's so obvious, but how could you say otherwise? She has just been a terrible campaigner. They've tried to hide her from the start. I mean, back 4 years ago, Joe Biden had an excuse. There was a COVID pandemic and they hid him in the basement. They've tried a similar strategy with Kamala Harris. And why? Well, because most times she's out public, in public, she embarrassed herself. I'll give her credit. She had a good debate. The first debate was good. There was no substance in it, but she showed a bit of pluck and she stood up and remembered her lines and she pushed back against Donald Trump a little bit. But that was her only good campaigning moment. It probably gave her a bit of momentum at the start, but since then they've been trying to hide her. And then late in the campaign, she's referencing Hitler, jumping on the John Kelly stories from the New York Times and actually saying to a live audience that Donald Trump is a fascist. This stuff is desperate and it's just not strong campaigning. She shows herself at every turn to be a bad campaigner. She doesn't think beyond the next question. She keeps talking up Joe Biden's record and his capacities, saying that there was nothing wrong with him as president, which completely undermines the reason for him not standing this time. And then she talks about how she was closely involved in everything they did in the administration, the Biden-Harris administration, and then she can't say anything that'd change, yet she's campaigning on change. And she's just promising more of the same. It's a really, really difficult campaign. They haven't really worked out what their pitch is. So I think Kamala Harris has been the big loser of the campaign, although with their ground game again, you never know what could happen when it comes to polling day.
You know it, you feel it. These guys are creepy and, yes, just weird as hell. That's what you see.
Who was the loser of the campaign? Tim Walz. What a terrible choice that was. If you look at who he is as a politician, it's as radical left as it gets. As the governor of Minnesota, he made sure there were tampons in boys' bathrooms. He made sure minors could travel to Minnesota for gender-affirming care. And now he's been trying to win over voters by acting like he's this relatable football coach, but he hasn't been able to pull that off. In fact, he's been the biggest joke of this campaign. He lied about his military service when he claimed he carried weapons in war. When he got caught out for those lies, he said it was bad grammar. He tanked in the VP debate against J.D. Vance, and he ended up admitting that he's bad at debating and blaming that on the fact that he's a school teacher.
I said, one thing is I told people, I said, I'm not that great a debater. I was a school teacher, so I'm trained to answer questions. You know, that's not a good debating skill.
But who's been even worse than Tim Walz is his wife, Gwen. She's done him no favours when she's been out campaigning, screaming, turn the page, while trying to blame Donald Trump for Joe Biden's disastrous leadership.
But I kind of liked it when she did this. Turn the page. You like that? Okay, so I need you to be with me and practice with me. What are we going to do? We're going to turn the page. Oh, pretty good. Do it again. We're going to turn the page. And we're going to turn the page. All right, so I'm going to be watching you because when I see Wisconsin and I'm watching nationally on TV because it's a pretty important place and Minnesota helped you practice with this, you just show me this. Turn the page. Right? Turn the page. And you know what else that looks like? Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Donald Trump. We are turning the page. 52 days and we are turning the page. 52 days and it is bye-bye, Donald Trump.
But if you really want to know who the loser of this campaign is, just ask Tim Walz's relatives who are openly campaigning for Donald Trump.
Hey! Wow! Well, hello, North Carolina!
The clear loser of this campaign had to have been Tim Walz. I mean, what business did that guy have being out there on the national stage with the prancing and the dancing and the this and everything else? He was just shoved out there. Basically, his first big campaign event was a debate with J.D. Vance, in which Vance basically annihilated him. And as he went on and on through the campaign, he just went from being, you know, this happy idiot goofball, like he was cast to be the white guy in a sitcom, to this very sort of dark and angry and pretty miserable creature. So, you know, he has not had a good campaign. He was well out of his depths. He was not seasoned, and it showed.
Elect me. I'm in the 20th century.
I really want to say Joe Biden because he really lost in this campaign. I think that it's Tim Walz because he was a guy nobody really knew about. He burst onto the scene and he got in Republicans' heads by talking about people being weird and they got obsessed with it and they didn't know how to respond to it. And then he stopped saying it and then he just disappeared. And when he reappeared, he was sort of goofy dancing, not Daggy Dad dancing. It was like borderline creepy dancing. So Walz, big loser.
Do you remember what that was like? Well, we are not going back. We are not going back. Not going back.
I'm not going to say Harris because, well, that's just so damn obvious. I think it's Walz because he's done the exact opposite of what J.D. Vance has done. Mm. Generally, you would like to think as a vice president that you are going to be the next in line to be the candidate for your party. But I think Walz has proven himself to be so weak through this campaign that even if Harris did win, they wouldn't look to him to be the next Democratic candidate for president.
I have to agree with that.
I obviously was going to, just because I'm annoyed, and I was going to go, well, everyone else is going to say Trump won and Kamala lost. And so I say, I'll go for the VPs and say that the biggest turnaround is Vance and the biggest reversal of fortune was Walz. But seeing as you guys have gone in, I'm just going to say it's Kamala all the way. This was her
gotta be different.
This was her election to lose. And I said that, you know, right at the very beginning when there was, you know, it seemed like she'd recovered from some of her massive gaffes that have defined her in the past. Mm. There was a very slick, too slick, but still very slick, well-orchestrated campaign around her. And I thought, surely she's been sort of coached and surely she's going to be a better public performer this time. And as soon as all that infrastructure disappears, she's just absolutely hopeless. So it was all her election to lose, and it looks like she's lost it.